The displacement effect is obtained through a black and white texture that varies the position of the vertices of a mesh based on the value of the corresponding pixels. If 0.5 represents non-variance at the mid-level, a higher value will represent a protrusion, while a smaller value is an indentation. Since the action occurs on the vertices, it is necessary that the mesh has a sufficient number of them to represent the desired shapes. This is why we often add several levels of subdivision before applying a displacement. All extreme PBR materials that are equipped with a suitable texture have a button to quickly activate displacement. The eye icon can deactivate the effect without resetting its parameters. Once turned on, blue, the effect can be edited via a pop-up panel. On top, we find a button to view the wireframe of the subdivided mesh. Next, we find the choice between modifiers and micro displacement modes, which only works with cycles and which we will see later. We set the type of subdivision, Catmull-Clark for rounded and interpolated shapes, or simple for subdividing only. Then we can set the number of subdivisions, separately for the viewport and for the render, keeping in mind that each level will increase the number of vertices exponentially. The value is limited to a maximum of 6 by scrolling the slider, but can be overwritten with even higher values by clicking and entering a number via the numeric keypad. The strength value sets the amount of effect applied. Using the mid-level slider, you can give an offset to the displacement. We can set a smoothing to avoid the formation of hard edges, and this smoothing can be repeated several times to increase softness. We can edit the brightness and contrast values of the texture to improve its effectiveness. Finally, the bake button applies the effect to the mesh permanently. By choosing the micro displacement option, the effect will only be visible on cycles and in rendered view mode. Blender version for point to and above will allow micro displacement in EV2. We find options for the amount of subdivisions and the possibility of activating adaptive subdivision, which automatically varies the subdivision levels based on the distance from the camera. With micro displacement, the strength of the effect is controlled by the bump amount. In case a mesh has 2 or more materials, it is necessary to limit the displacement to the correct group of vertices. This is easily achieved by clicking on the Smart Separator button. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel to stay updated on news.